In this video, we'll use LoggerNet to connect to our data logger, send a program, view real-time data, collect data, and finally view the collected data. From the main category of the LoggerNet toolbar, click Connect. Select which station to connect to. Connect. Once connected, this graphic indicates your connection state and you'll notice the elapsed time increasing. Connect and collect. That's a good habit to get into. Collect your data before doing anything else. We'll look more at this later when we collect our data generated by our program. Now we'll send the program we wrote in shortcut to the data logger. Click Send and navigate to your program. Mine is in the Campbell Sci SCWin folder. Open. You are warned that sending a new program will delete any existing data stored on the data logger. Since we just collected data, click Yes. The program is sent and compiled. Take a look at the compile results to make sure there are no errors, messages, or warnings. If there were any, they'd show up in this area. You can also see what operating system, or OS, is running on your data logger. Now let's take a look at some of the details of the running program. The Table Fill Times tab shows all the tables storing data and about how much time you had before the newest data starts to overwrite the oldest data on the data logger. Click OK when you're done. Now let's take a look at our public table and the table monitor. Remember, the public table is where our measurement values are updated every program scan, every 1 second in this exercise. Our shortcut program takes three measurements. The battery voltage that reads zero when powered by USB, again, that's to remind you that you need a 12-volt battery for field deployment, the processing board temperature labeled P-temp, and the temperature as measured by our thermocouple. At room temperature, it should read around 22, which is in degrees Celsius. If it reads NAN, or not a number, go back to shortcut and check your wiring diagram. Touch the tip of the thermocouple with your fingers and watch the measured value change. If it goes down, that usually means you have it wired backwards. Go back to shortcut and check your wiring. Once the data logger has been running your program for a while, you should collect and look at the data. Connect and collect. It's a good habit. We're already connected, so I'll click Collect Now. The data collection results show how much data you have collected and where it is stored on your computer. We use the defaults in our easy setup. Notice that it says daily table is inaccessible or does not exist. That's because our data logger has not been running through the midnight hour yet. Tomorrow, there will be a record in that table. Select a table with data. I'll pick 1min and View File. ViewPro shows the data file that's been copied from the data logger to your computer. When you're done, close this window. Close again. And you're back to the Connect screen. We've covered a lot in this Quick Start tutorial. The CR300 and LoggerNet have many other features to discover. Watch our other video tutorials, download and read the Quick Start section of the CR300 manual, or contact a Campbell Scientific application engineer to discuss your application and for answers about getting started with your CR300.